How you doing? My name is Paul McCormick. I'm the owner of Great Gun Shellfish. Great Gun was started in 2013, and the name came from a location directly south from the farm. It's called a place called Great Gun Beach. And thought the name was great, no pun intended, but yeah, I grew up from a very young age being connected to the water, having an intimate relationship with the water, fishing and crabbing and clamming, you know, since the time I was 5 years old. Basically, I lived a block away from the water in Southwestern Bay, a town called Massapequa, and it's just, you know, it's something that if you spend a lot of time on the water and you're, you know, involved in things like fishing and clamming, it sort of gets into your blood, and at least for me, it's sort of a haunting kind of reality, because you know, I took a long break from working on the water. I worked as a clammer full time back in the 1990s, and that was just sort of a logical extension of my growing up. But then I took a long break, but in that, all those years in between, you know, I couldn't pass over a bridge looking at the Great South Bay or drive along the Ocean Parkway where I'd look out at the bay and feel, you know, that I longed for it. It's sort of, that kind of longing built up over a long period of time, and I sort of, it's almost like a haunting feeling until the point where I said, you know, I have to get back to the bay. And so in 2012, I heard about the start of this aquaculture, small-scale aquaculture environment that we're in now. Once I heard about folks growing oysters, I said, wow, that's interesting. That's how I found my way back to the bay. Everybody here on the East Coast farms one specific oyster. It's the native oyster of, you know, the East Coast of the United States, which is called the Eastern Oyster, Chrysostrea virginica. But, you know, a good way to understand oysters is, even though we're all growing the same species, they vary according to the environment, and you can think of wine the same way. You can grow the same grape in 5 different pieces of land, and that grape is going to be, the wine that grape produces is going to taste different, and it's the same thing with oysters. So even though we all grow the same species of oyster, we all have our own names for each of our oysters, often named after our companies or our farms, and each oyster really does taste different from each other. Shellfish aquaculture has a real positive impact on the environment, with few, if any, drawbacks. Unlike other forms of aquaculture, we're not introducing an artificial food source into the water or associated pesticides or any other type of chemicals. We're basically putting an indigenous species back into its environment. It feeds on the algae that are naturally there. Oysters are natural filters. They clean and filter. Mature oyster can clean and filter up to 50 gallons of water a day. So, you know, you multiply that by 600,000 or 700,000 oysters on the farm, and you're filtering, you know, a sizable amount of water. We also grow sugar kelp on the farm right now, and that's a great nitrogen uptake and nitrogen mitigator. So that's also having a positive impact. And also the physical structure of oyster farms provides new habitat for various marine life, fishes and crabs and crustaceans. So it's really a unique form of aquaculture that, again, really has very few drawbacks and is way on the net positive side.